of class 7 from IYS school. Dear students, assalamu alaikum and a very good morning to all of you. And hope you all will be fine. Our today's unit number 6. Before starting our unit, I want to give some instructions which you have to follow. So listen carefully. You all have to do your work in your fair copies. Your copies should be divided in two parts. First part is for actual exercises and the second part is for composition work like letter, essays, application. And you all know, before starting every unit, you all have to draw a title page of the lesson. Then you will make the outline and then all exercises like words, meaning and question answers. Dear students, if you want to ask any question, if you have any difficulty during lesson, so you can note down on a paper and can ask at the end of the lesson through chat. Dear students, you can take screenshots of words meaning and other notes like words meaning and question answer, which I will share with you. Now come towards the unit. So open your course book, page number 75, unit number 6. The history of women's cricket. But before starting this unit, I want to share some information about the writer of this unit. The students, do you know who is the writer of this unit? Yes, Rosalind Ferguson. She was a former teacher, is a freelance writer and editor with a wide range of reference works to her name. She lived in Kent. Kent is a country in southeastern England. So she lived in Kent with her husband David and occupied her leisure time with walking, sailing, literature and music. So it was a little introduction about the writer Rosalind Ferguson. Now the introduction about the unit. In this unit, we will learn about the background of a game, women's cricket. Students, usually we see the boys have been playing this game in streets and grounds, but now girls are also showing their abilities in this game, cricket. So students, in this unit, we will learn about the history of women's cricket, that how and when did it start. We will also learn about some famous players and legends of women's cricket in this unit. So students, as you know, this unit is consist on 11 passages, so I will explain all these one by one. Now let's start the lesson. So I will read only the first passage as a model reading, and you have underlined the new words from this passage during reading. So let's start the passage number one. That's not cricket. This exclamation has entered the English language as an idiom. Underline the word idiom. Dear students, underline the word idiom. Idiom means a manner of speaking, a mode of expression. Used when one person does something that another person considers to be unfair or unsportsmanlike. The implication is that. Next word we will underline, implication. Underline this word, implication. The meaning of this word, the state of being implicated. The implication is that cricket traditionally called, traditionally. Next word you will underline, traditionally. Traditionally means in a traditional manner. It means from the beginning. So, traditionally called the game of gentlemen. Sets the standard for fair play. Whether the players are professional sportsmen or villagers who got together for an informal match, they are expected to treat each other as gentlemen would, with honesty and respect for many years. However, it was felt that the sport behaved very unfairly towards a group of people who make up half of the world's population, women. So students, now I will explain this passage, so listen carefully. First, I will explain the meaning of expression. Do you know what is expression? Like, if we say, that's not fair, that's not good, so that's like, that's not cricket. It is also an expression. In English language, this idiom is used when a person does something that another person considers to be unfair. And in any kind of game, this word is used as unsportsmanlike. So, from the beginning, the cricket is called the game of gentlemen. It's mean this game shows the standard for fair play. Whether the players are professional or villagers, they are expected to treat each other in a gentle way. It means even they are beaten in game, they should not show rude behavior with their fellows and others. They should respect and be honest with their game. For a long time, sport has been considered very unfair regarding those people who design half of the world's population, women. So it was the explanation of the first passage. Hope you understood. Now we will move towards the next passage, passage number 2. Here, the Melbourne Cricket Club. You will underline the words Melbourne. You can see the word MCC is stand for Melbourne Cricket Club. And the next word you can see in bold letter, bastion. Bastion, it means, you can see at the end of the speech, bastion means a place or group of people that protects the traditions, principles, and standards of an activity. Now you will underline the next word from this passage, LBW. LBW, you can see in the fourth line, LBW. So, underline this word, LBW. L is for leg, B is for before, and W is for wicket. It means leg before wicket. And the next word from this passage, overarm bowling style. Overarm bowling style, it is a technique of bowling with hand brought forward and down from above shoulder level. So, you will underline the next word, no ball. The last word of this passage, no ball. It means it is an illegal delivery to a batsman in cricket. No ball is an illegal delivery to a batsman. So, dear students, now I'm going to explain this passage. Listen carefully. Melbourne Cricket Club. Melbourne Cricket Club is a cricket club founded in 1787 at Lord's Cricket Ground in London. In 1788, the MCC took responsibility for the laws of cricket, issuing a revised version that year. Further, actually in this passage, some rules of bowling are defined by the writer. So there are many types of no ball in cricket. It means when the bowler's front foot crosses the line completely before releasing the ball, it is called no ball. Also, if a ball qualifies as a no ball as well as a wide, the umpire will call it no ball and not a wide. So it's all about the bowling techniques. Now we will move towards the next passage, passage number 3. So listen carefully, students. Now you will underline some new words from this passage. So first word is restricted. Underline this word, restricted. It's mean limited, not free to move. Limited, not free to move. Now, underline the next word, domestic. In third line, you can see domestic. Domestic means relating to activities. Relating to activities. And the next word, underline the word pavilion. Pavilion, as you know, a building next to a sports ground used by players and spectators. Now, I will explain this passage. So, listen, till the end of 20th century. Dear students, this passage is all about the membership of MCC. Till the end of 20th century, the membership of MCC was limited to men. But in September 1998, the decision was taken to admit to female members in MCC. So until 1999, women, except Queen Elizabeth II, were not permitted to enter the pavilion as members during play due to the gender-based membership policy of MCC. At last, Melbourne Cricket Club proudly displayed its first female member and Lord's Cricket Ground opened its door for the women. Now, we will learn about the passage number 4. Turn your page. Here you can see passage number 4. So we will underline some new words from this passage. The first word is meanwhile. Meanwhile means the time between two events. It means the time between two events. It means during the time that something is happening. Now, the next word is enthusiasm. Enthusiasm means intensity of feeling, excited, interest or eagerness. Now, the next word is confined. Confined means restricted or limited. Restricted or limited. Now, the next word, the last word of this passage, counterparts. Counterparts means a person or thing having the same function. A person or thing having the same function. Now, I'm going to explain this passage. Okay, dear students, listen. Since the 18th century, cricket had been famous among the women. Women played it with great zeal. On 26 July 1745, the history of women's cricket can be traced back to a report in the Reading Mercury. What is Reading Mercury? It was an English newspaper. So, in an English newspaper, an article was published regarding a match that took place between the villagers of Bramley and Hamilton. The Bramley mad had blue ribbons and the Hamilton mads had red ribbons on their heads and all dressed in white. Here the age of players are also defined that they were teenage girls against the women of middle age. So it was the explanation of this passage. Now we will move towards the passage number 5. In passage number 5, underline some new words. The first word you will underline, entangled. Entangled. The meaning of entangled means twisted, caught or caught. Twisted or caught. Now the next word is discredited. Discredited. It means being unjustly brought into disrepute. Discredited means being unjustly brought into disrepute. Now, the next word is hailed. Hailed. Hailed means recognized. Recognized or famous for. So, dear student, now I will explain this passage according to the legend. So, the legend said about the Christina Willis. Christina, who was Christina Willis? She was the pioneer of round arm bowling. She was the pioneer of round arm bowling. In cricket, this type of bowling is familiar as overarm technique. So, when she bowled underarm, her hand twisted in her skirt. When she bowled underarm, her hand twisted in her skirt, unluckily from those days, she has been unjustly brought into disrepute. So because of women, she has not been considered a pioneer of round arm bowling. While a male cricketer, Tom Walker, is now famous as a pioneer. So it was the explanation of passage number 5. Now we will move towards the passage number 6. But first, we will underline some new words from the passage number 6. Now, first word from the passage number 6, patronizing. You will underline the patronizing. Patronizing means talk to someone in a way that shows you think they are stupid or inferior than you. It means talk to someone in a way that shows you think they are stupid or inferior than you. Now, underline next word, induce. Induce means pursuit. Pursuit or support for. Pursuit or support for. Now, the next word is attained. Next word is attained. means achieved. Achieved or to gain with effort. Achieved or to gain with effort. Now, I'm going to explain passage number 6. In this passage, the writer explained the contribution of original English lady cricketers. In this passage, the writer explained the contribution of original English lady cricketers. Actually, the game was being played professionally in England after 19th century. After 19th century, by two touring team known as the original English ladies cricketers would draw huge crowds. It was the passage number 6. Now we will move towards the next page, page number 77. So dear students, turn your page number 77. Here you can see passage number 7 on page number 77. Now I'm going to explain this passage because I did not find any new words from this passage. So dear students, if you want to ask any new meaning of any new words, so you can ask at the end of the lesson through chat. So I will also explain this passage. Okay, listen. It's all about the popularity of women's cricket. So women's cricket soon gained popularity in many countries. Women's cricket soon gained popularity in many countries, especially in Australia. And then other countries, including New Zealand, South Africa, the West Indies, etc. Now, the first Australian club for female cricketers was established in 1894 under the leadership of a young Tasmanian lady called Lily Pollute-Harris. Who was Lily Pollute-Harris? She was an Australian female cricketer and she was also the captain of women's cricket team. So Lily Pollute-Harris, she was a young Tasmanian lady and whose brother was a member of the state cricket team. She led her team successfully and got many victories in her short career. Because she died of tuberculosis. Tuberculosis means a kind of infectious disease. You can see a kind of disease, TB, tuberculosis means. So Lily Pollute-Harris died of tuberculosis at the age of 23 years in 1897. But she got many victories in her short career. So now, students, I will explain the passage number 8. Here you can see in the passage number 8, here I did not find any new words from this passage. So I will only explain this passage. So listen this passage, I'm going to explain passage number 8. In this passage, the writer defined about one of the first women members and a former England women's cricket captain, Rachel Hahoy Flint. She was born in 1939. Rachel Hahoy Flint was born in 1939. She played for the England women cricket team from 1960 to 1970. It's all about the female cricketer. She was a captain of England women's cricket team and she played from 1960 to 1970. So in her captainship, remember students, in her captainship, in Rachel Hahoy Flint's captainship, the team won the first ever Women's Cricket World Cup in 1973. In Rachel Hahoy Flint's captainship, the team won the first ever Women's Cricket World Cup in 1973. So, after retirement from cricket, she devoted her life for writing and broadcasting. Broadcasting means a program sent on radio and TV. So Rachel Hahoy Flint spent her life after retirement in writing and broadcasting. So it's all about the Rachel Hahoy Flint. Now we will move towards the passage number 9. But before starting the explanation of this passage, I will share some new words from the passage number 9. Here you can see from passage number 9, our word ineligible. Ineligible, underline this word, ineligible. It means not eligible. It means not eligible. Now, the next word you can underline from this passage, rebuff. Rebuff. Rebuff means an expression of anger, an expression of anger or disapproval. Or disapproval. Now, the next word you can underline this from this passage, abolition. Abolition means the act of abolishing a system. The act of abolishing a system. Now, the next word you will underline, antique. Antique. Antique means so extremely old as seeming to belong to an earlier period. So extremely old as seeming to belong to an earlier period. Now, the next word you will underline, norm. Norm. N-O-R-M. Norm. The meaning of this word is average or a standard. Average or a standard. Now, I'm going to explain this passage. It's all about the Hare Flint, the first woman England captain, women's cricket team. So, Hare Flint, after retirement, Hare Flint applied to join MCC in 1991. Are you listening, students? I will explain. I'm explaining the passage number 9. Hare Flint applied to join the MCC in 1991. But she was refused. But she was refused. Although there was no doubt in her skills and achievements as compared to male. As compared to male. But she was a woman. That's why she was not qualified. So, this unkind behavior motivated her to get rid of this old-fashioned rule. This unkind behavior motivated her to get rid of this old-fashioned rule. Actually, she wanted to abolish this old system. So, from the 21st century was coming near, 21st century was coming near, and equality was showing in every walk of life. So it was the explanation of passage number 9. Hope you understood. Now we will learn about the passage number 10. Here, passage number 10. At last, Hare Flint. In passage number, I'm going to explain the passage number 10. You can understand easily. At last, Hare Flint was chosen to be one of the first 10 female members. At last, Hare Flint was chosen to be one of the first 10 female members of MCC, including Audrey Collins. Audrey Collins, who was Audrey Collins? She was the former president of the Women's Cricket Association. She was the former president of Women's Cricket Association. So, Audrey Collins began playing in 1930 and continued for more than 40 years. So, the women's team was formed. It was Hare Flint. It was Hare Flint, along with 9 other women, was granted membership of the MCC in 1999. Remember, students, it was Hare Flint, Rachel Hare Flint, along with 9 other women, was granted membership of MCC in 1999 and played its first match a few months later. Thanks to her long campaign for the equal rights of women in the international sporting arena. Thanks to Rachel Hare Flint. To her long campaign for the equal rights of women in the international sporting arena. So, students, hope you got it. Now, we will read the passage number 11. This is the last passage. So turn your page, page number 78. Here you can see the last passage. So in this passage, in the last passage, the writer said, at last the women's sport got the equal status with the men's. The women's sport got the equal status with the men's. Here, Tony Lewis was he was the president of the MCC. So the Tony Lewis encouraged the women in the last passage, in these words. The words are included into inverted commas. So the Tony Lewis encouraged the women in these words. We could not claim to be a great cricket club. We could not claim to be a great cricket club unless we had a women's team and women members. So in these words, the Tony Lewis encouraged the women. So the students hope you have understood clearly. So the whole lesson has been explained now. Hope you all have understood it. Now we will move towards the words meaning, which I have already explained you, but now I will read it again. And students, you can also take the screenshots of these words meaning. The first word is idiom. The meaning of this word is a manner of speaking. A manner of speaking. Next word is bastion. Bastion means a group of people that protects the principals. Next word is pavilion. Pavilion, a building next to a sports ground used by players and spectators. Next word, rebuff. Rebuff, an expression of an anger. The meaning of a rebuff is an expression of an anger. Now the next word, discredited. Discredited means being unjustly brought into disrepute. Being unjustly brought into disrepute. You can take a screenshot, students. Have you taken? Now we will move towards the next slide. Here you can see some more words meaning. I will read pioneer. Pioneer means groundbreaker or innovator. Groundbreaker or innovator. Now the next word, confined. Confined means restricted or limited. Next word, enthusiasm. Enthusiasm, intensity of feeling, excited, interest or eagerness. Now the next word, entangled. Entangled means twisted or caught. Next word, held. It means recognized or famous for. Next word, tuberculosis. Tuberculosis, an infectious disease. It means TB. Next word is for encouragement. God. So students, you can take a screenshot of these words meaning. So you have to do in your copies, this work in your copies. Now we will move towards the words meaning question answers. Now these are the questions which you have to do in your copies. Here, so the first question is, where was women's cricket first played? Next question is, who was the pioneer of round-arm bowling? Third question is, write down two similarities and two differences between Lily Pulliot Harris and Rachel Hawthorne. And the question number four is, make a timeline for women's cricket, naming at least five key events. And the question number five is, summarize what the passage tells us about bowling techniques. Now I will share the question, the answers of these questions. So you can take the screenshots. Now the first question is, where was women's cricket first played? It was first played in Southern England. It was first played in Southern England. Now the next question is, who was the pioneer of round-arm bowling? Who was the pioneer of round-arm bowling? The answer is Tom Walker. The legend that it was Christina Willis has been discredited. Tom Walker, the legend that it was Christina Willis has been discredited. So you can take a screenshot. Now we will move towards the next question. Question number three. Dear students, The question number three is, write down two similarities and two differences between Lily Pollute Harris and Rachel Hayhoe. Here I have an example for you. You will do the answer like this. Here you have to make two columns for similarities and differences like this, and then you will do the answer of this question like this. You can take the screenshots. First, in first column you will write the similarities. And in the next column, you will write the differences. The similarities are, both were keen and skilled cricketers. In the first column, you can write the similarities. Both were keen and skilled cricketers. And the next similarity is, both were captains of their teams. And now, differences. What are the differences between Lily Pollute Harris and Rachel Hayhoe, Clint? So, Lily was Australian, whereas Rachel was English. And the next difference, Lily died young, whereas Rachel lived for more than 70 years. So you can take a screenshot. And now we will move towards the next question, question number four. Here I have an example. Make a timeline for women's cricket, naming at least five key. You can take screenshots of this timeline. 1745, a women's cricket match was played in Southern England. In 1894, the first Australian women's cricket club was founded. And in 1973, the first women's cricket World Cup was held. Take a screenshot, students. Now, we will move towards the next slide. Here, in 1998, the MCC decided to begin admitting female members, and in 1999 the first match was played by a female MCC team. So the students, you can take screenshots and you have to do this work in your copy. And then now the next question, summarize what the passage tells us about bowling techniques. The answer of this question is, the ball was originally bowled underarm, then the round arm technique was introduced. This evolved into the overarm technique, which is now used, though it was originally illegal. So it was the answer of question number five. Hope you got it and you can take screenshots. Okay, have you taken? Now this is your homework. Copy down words meaning and question answers and learn it. This is your home task. Now students, hope you have understood clearly. Inshallah, we will learn about prefix and vocabulary and adverbs and grammar in our next class. So this is the time of